Hey guys, it's TownieSimBuilds here, and welcome back to another build challenge. Now, by the time you guys are viewing this, I do believe the Sims 4 for Rent expansion pack will already be out. But with that said, I did want to do one more challenge themed around the pack, and what better way to do so than in the snowy world of Mount Komorebi? Now, just like the title says, I will be trying to build a 32-tile hotel. So if you guys own the Tiny Living Pack, that is considered a micro home. So that is the smallest tier I can go. I'm going to try and hopefully squeeze in 3 units and hopefully some nice amenities as well. Apart from that, I don't really have any restrictions, but I think the size speaks for itself. With that being said, I did choose this very wonderful snowy lot in the world of Mount Komorebi, and it's only 30 by 20, so it should be more than enough for a 32-tile hotel, and I'm just gonna cross my fingers and hope for the best with this one. All right, so let's get things started. We're gonna open up the tiny home residential panel here. And like I said, there are only 32 tiles, so the rooms are going to be super small. I don't think we can do a double bed situation, but I will try to create little tiny compartments just like this. Okay, so already 3 rooms is 24 tiles. They barely have room for anything. I'm thinking we could do maybe one bed, like a single sleeper bed in each one. And then maybe a very small bathroom in each one. I think we're already gonna run out of tiles, so this is not going to be good. We are officially 1 tile over, which is not too great. Maybe I can do a diagonal and save some tiles that way. All right, it didn't do much. It still kept the tile count the same, which is awful. I thought I could save like 1.5 tiles. I would love to go with a more traditional Japanese design. Maybe a ryokan would be cool. But again, the community space is going to be all outside, and that really is part of the challenge. Part of the challenge, which I completely forgot to mention, was of course being on this very snowy lot, so we still have to stay warm outside even though our hotel is super small. Alright, we're at 27 tiles now, so we can add, I believe, 1 more to each one, and I think that's all we can go, unfortunately. So let me do this, I'll just add some on like so. And then we have a whopping 2 tiles left, which it's looking bleak, you guys. I wanted some kind of check-in space, but I don't know how it would work with this arrangement. Technically, the check-in space would only have 2 tiles, so there's not really much to work with. I feel like the check-in space would almost be like a little booth, so maybe I could put it perhaps farther out in the snow like this. And just like that, you guys, the 32 tiles is completely gone. This is just about it. So let me go ahead and actually create a larger space like this. I may also change the layout a little bit because it's a little weird, if I'm being honest. But perhaps I could put these on stilts just like this. This is going to be one of the saddest hotels ever. However, if you use this in game, it would be very cheap to own, I would imagine. So there's at least that benefit. All right, definitely gonna pull some of this from the snowy escape pack. Some nice wood paneled walls here. I did want the stilted foundation as well. I just don't really know if stairs are going to count as actual tiles, so that could be a little bit problematic. Let me actually test out the bed situation because I need to make sure this is going to fit. We could perhaps do one of these just like this. It's a very tight fitting space, if I'm being honest with you guys. I do have the potential to do bunk beds though, if we do want to sleep more individuals in these rooms. Question is, do we have anything that matches the style? Probably not, so that's going to be a little bit problematic. I'm probably going to go for something a little bit more plain, maybe like this. Kind of has those nice tones of an icy blue, kind of going with the theme. Alright, at the very least, even if you are a couple, there will be a bed for each person in the unit, so it's perfect for friends, roommates, you name it. Yeah, at least there's that. We do have space to sleep 6 people in total in this very, very tiny hotel. So there it is. That's the benefit. Definitely going to use more paneling from the Snowy Escape pack. So probably something like this, going with the darker wood like so. For the flooring, we could possibly go with tatami, but I'm not really sure how it's going to lay out. I'm going to do my best interpretation and hopefully it does suffice. I think it would wrap around somewhere like this in order to achieve the right effect. So it's not a perfect space for this, so I apologize if it's not very authentic, but I do like the look and feel. The entryway though, that is going to be a little bit tricky. I do have to put stairs in and see how that fits, and I hope it does not add more tiles, because if it does, I am kind of in a tough spot here because there's no way to get up. Ooh, it does not add tiles. Okay, that's perfect. So let's do this. We're gonna add a little stairway to each of the units. I think it'll give us enough space to put a door over here, so that way we're not invading directly into the bed space. Let's go for this door again from Snowy Escape with some nice wooden slats. The question is, was there a way to lay this out more efficiently? Because we do need a full bathroom here, which is a little tricky. I can put a toilet, I can put a shower here with the Snowy Escape option, and then the sink all the way towards the right. So it's not too bad. So let me try it out. This time, I think we will go with a tile just to break up the wood paneling a little bit. So I'm thinking we could do perhaps something from the Spa Day pack. Probably something like this is not too bad. Let's use this as our base. And let's just get the amenities in there. The standing shower of dreams. Here we go. This is the solution. This is the solution to my small bathroom problem. So here we go. I think this is going to do the trick. Ooh, yes. This is looking better. I'm gonna use Spa Day instead. And then for the floor, I'm still not quite sure. I think it has to be a tile because we do have the drainage system embedded into the floor. Let's do Spa Day once more and probably go for a tile. Perhaps something like this. I think this is not too bad. For lighting, we can probably go just a little bit more traditional. I'm gonna pull from the Snowy Escape pack, so maybe one of these lanterns. They're really big, so I will size it down twice, and I think this will do the trick here. All right, gotta put the sink in place. Probably gonna go for something more modern. I could do something like this from the Seasons pack, which I do believe fits the overall aesthetic, so this could be great. And on top of that, I do think we can use the mirror that came with this pack as well. So if I could find you, that would be great. Aha, there we are. Perfect. And then the toilet will be over here in the corner. And I really like this kind of more high-tech option from the Snowy Escape pack, so something like this could be cool. Or we could even do some Spa Day here as well, which does also fit the look. All right, what else do we need here? We do need a little bit of a soap holder because we don't have anything like that in this bathroom. So let's do this. Could we have some fancy soap from Spa Day? Yes, we can. Perfect. Scale down like this. And I do think we can also add some hand soap here, which is absolutely perfect. I think the bathroom actually turned out quite nice. Maybe nicer than the bedroom itself, which I'm a little concerned about. So maybe we can spruce it up a little bit. I'm gonna bring these back out over here. I think the one thing I do wanna change is probably the wood. I think the tone I used was a little bit too dark. So let me lighten that up to match the bathroom. Could we actually do wood? That's a good question. Because we could do this. Ooh, okay. I think I actually like this better, so let's scratch the tatami for now, and maybe I'll get a nice cushy rug for your Sims as well, so hopefully that can help them stay warm. We're not really gonna have a space for belongings, so I'm not really sure where those are going to go. However, I do have the clothing rack object from the Snowy Escape pack, so it holds like hats and coats and snowboards, so maybe that could be used kind of like a dresser. It might be a little bit of a stretch, but I think we can make it work. And here you are, perfect. So let's use this. I think your Sims can still get by, and it adds just a nice element of clutter to the space as well. I am wondering, however, if we can sneak in a fridge, and I think the best bet is probably this one from the Spa Day pack. I think your Sims can get in here, so I'm gonna cross my fingers and hope for the best. I think cucumbers and quick meals are in here, so that shouldn't be too bad. What can we do to utilize this space? That is a good question. We could potentially do a TV in here. So maybe I can use this object from the Tiny Living pack and just kind of bop it up over the fridge itself. And if I scale it down even more, I think it actually will fit even better. So maybe something like this. All right, guys, so this shape is kind of bothering me. I think I made a really weird decision here. So what I'm going to do is actually shift this bathroom down, and I will try to realign the contents inside. This part, though, is going to be a little tricky because I'm not really sure what's going to go along this wall. We could do a painting, perhaps. I'm not really sure if that's going to fit. I'm thinking an object from the Snowy Escape pack, so maybe something like this could do, and maybe just put it along here. I will say, though, this room is quite small. It can feel possibly a little claustrophobic, so I'm not really sure how we're going to put windows in this space. Oh, on the other side, I could lose this painting, which I do want to keep. Maybe I can scale it down and put it next to the door itself like this. All right, for the windows, let's see what would make a good fit. Could do a window like this and possibly stack them on top of each other. All right, could we add more windows? Maybe. Maybe we can squeeze some up here, perhaps. I don't really know if there's going to be a lot of room. This is kind of big, but I think it may actually fit. I'm just gonna bump it up to the very edge of the wall and try to get it as close to the ceiling as I can. All right, we do have clearance for the TV and we do have clearance for the bed, so I think this is gonna work out fine. I think overall everything is pretty much complete with the bedroom because we don't have a lot of space, and I think it's actually fairly cozy overall. All right, let's go ahead and delete this room for now because I don't really think it's helping us, and I'm just going to copy and paste this unit over with a few little adjustments. I do want to add some railings as well just for a little bit of safety, and I will also go with the matching ones from the Snowy Escape pack, so this should complete the look. We do also have the roofs to worry about, which I'm wondering how I'm going to use. I don't believe they take up any more spaces, so I think we should be fine there. Let's do perhaps a hipped roof like this. Just kind of expand it over. And right away, I don't think I spaced these out very well, so that's a problem. Could I do a more uniform roof, perhaps, if I stretch it over the whole thing? Ooh, okay, I think this actually feels a little bit more hotel-like. I don't know if I want to keep those spaces, though. That is something I'm really not sure about. I think we can do that for now, just to give the units a little bit more privacy. And maybe I can add another roof in the middle like this, perhaps for some signage. I do want to pull the signage from the Snowy Escape pack as well, which I do believe is for an onsen, so it should do the trick there. Oh, I totally forgot the space heaters. Can we fit these in? Maybe, but there's not really a lot of space. I think perhaps I could put it along the window like this, and I don't think your Sims would be blocked off. Everything else is fairly fitting. I will just vary some of these swatches just so it's not so repetitive. Back to the sign, you guys. Where is this thing? It's a small wooden glowing sign, which unfortunately I'm not seeing. Ooh. Actually, it's right here. Perfect. So we'll do this. We're going to shrink it down a little bit. All right, we do have this option, which I think works. We do have a mountain here and what looks like some kind of heating source. I think this is actually the hot spring, which I do want to include here. So I think this works perfectly. With that said, I will briefly switch this to the night view because I do need to see what the lighting situation looks like here. And of course, we do need some outdoor lights as well. Could do these hanging lanterns. They actually look pretty interesting. And I think I can put them maybe above the door over here. All right, so here it is. This is the hotel as it stands at night, which I actually do enjoy quite a bit. I think the thing we need to do is figure out what to do with the last two tiles and then figure out the whole landscaping situation. I'm thinking of doing a smaller fence, so maybe something like this from the Island Living pack, just so the lot has a little bit of a border. My gosh, you guys, I cannot see where the grid lines end. It's a complete guessing game, but I think it's roughly centered. I'm going to move up the lot just a little bit because I do want some space for a hot spring, and I'll probably place it roughly in the backyard area. The question is, I do need to see if the roof is going to cost anything because I would like some kind of overhang back here. All right, the lot is finally enclosed so I can officially see all of the lot boundaries, so that's great. I will try to fit in some kind of check-in booth outside, which is going to be a little bit weird. It's probably going to feel like a parking booth, but you know what, I think that is the best I can do here, and I will give it a little bit of height as well to match with the other buildings. Let's do probably another platform base. I could also do stone. This may not be too bad as well. The problem is people can't really reach this. People cannot reach the check-in desk if it's all the way up here. I do think I have to sacrifice the platform beneath it, which honestly, I'm okay with. I can do a little bit of bumpage just like this, and I think it should be sufficient. Unfortunately, the whole wood paneling doesn't work here. If you guys have used panels like this, you can see that the edge is not really registering on each side. So unfortunately, I do have to change this out, but I'll probably just use the alternate version of this wall piece and use this one here. All right, for the check-in desk, we do need some sort of window. And I'm thinking we could possibly do maybe something like this with maybe a little bit of space underneath, and then maybe just a small shelf out front as well. So if you're signing paperwork, perhaps out in the cold, I would say, we do have a little area for that. We do need a way to get in. So let's pull possibly these stairs, which don't even match. They don't even match, you guys. So let me fix that really quickly. Probably gonna do the same thing right about here with just a little bit of an area to step out. and I will use the same door as well. All right, desks, you guys. The desks are going to be very slim pickings, but I do think we have the option from the tiny living pack. Maybe something like this. This is not too bad. Problem is, I don't think you can actually get in. So there is a mistake on my part. We could do this. I think this will fit a little better, even though it's simpler. And I guess if we're going to access the computer, I think we will have to go from maybe the other side. I'm not really sure. I can put it maybe over here. You know, if your Sims cannot access this, I am so sorry. I'm pretty sure in real life someone could kind of scoochy scooch in there. But Sims, you know, they need a lot of space to enter certain objects. So, yeah. I'm not really banking on this being fully functional, but it's for the look. It's for the look. It's for the realism. So I think that'll have to do. I'm going to put in a nice comfy chair with a nice cushion and possibly a pretty nice computer as well. Probably this option from the Get to Work pack. I think it would be nice to have maybe some flyers on the wall. You know, if you have brochures for sightseeing or restaurants, perhaps, that could be really cool. These could be a lot of things. These could be advertisements. Maybe there is a local noodle shop or a karaoke bar in town. Yeah, I think these will work pretty well. All right, so that is our tiny, tiny check-in area. It's gonna have to do, but I don't really mind it. Apart from that, we do need a lot of landscaping because it is very barren here. But I will go to the debug menu now and of course revisit Snowy Escape. We do have a lot of evergreen trees here as well, so that could be an option. I'm not really too familiar with a lot of the flora in Japan, especially in the mountains, so I'm assuming bigger, burlier trees could do the trick. We do have these, which have lost their leaves, but they still look pretty interesting. Probably gonna go for some of the safer options because we do have trees like this, which I think are fairly fitting. And we also have these evergreen trees as well, which are kind of part of the natural landscape here. So if I vary some of these, I think these trees will be a really good fit. Now we will have the onsen farther back here, so I'm thinking I will need taller fences just for a little bit of privacy. So I will go back and add those, and I think I'll pull again from the Snowy Escape pack, which, you know, it's fitting. I think it's going to work out just fine. On that note, I would also like a little bit more in terms of perhaps some stones, perhaps some foliage everywhere. I do think some of these stones could do the trick. I do like how the snow kind of falls over them in the wintertime, so I will scatter these around the lot as well. All right, I think we are good with the snow here. I was thinking of doing stepping stones, but if I'm being honest with you guys, I think the snow is going to absolutely cover them, especially if the stepping stones are a completely flat texture. So let me look at base game. I do know that they are in here somewhere. And here you are. Okay, perfect. Let's use these. If I put them in the ground, they do disappear. You can see a very faint outline, but you know what, you guys? I don't really think it's worth it. So I will have to try and use other objects. First, let us fix the fencing. I will use the Snowy Escape fence, and I will go for, I believe, the taller bamboo option that is in the game. Not too bad. I do think the darker wood is probably a little bit more fitting. So let's do this, and I will extend it through the whole lot just like this, and maybe a little bit along this way as well. All right, I think this is looking good. We do have more privacy towards the back. I will now go in and add the onsen, so it'll be a natural spring. And I will use, where are you? Where is it? Okay. And perfect, here we go. Now, major kudos to anyone who would go out in the freezing cold to a hot spring. I feel like I've seen people do this in real life, and I'm not really sure what the effect is on your body, but I don't know, you guys. I don't have the guts to try it out, but here it is. Here it is in the backyard of the hotel. All right, so we are in the night view now, and I think the best option we have is probably going to be this. We're going to use these stone lanterns and create a little bit of a lighted walkway to the natural spring itself. So let me just wrap these around the hotel units. I could also place some over here as well if I just want to put one by the door, and perhaps I can just shrink it down just a little bit like this. All right, and I do think we could use some kind of grand archway, which I have seen some in debug, so I think that's a really good possibility. So let's go to debug now. We will go back to Snowy Escape. Obviously, this build is very heavily reliant on this pack, but honestly, you guys, the objects are great. They obviously fit with the world, so that's a plus. And of course, we are going for that wintry theme, so here we are. I do even love these little picnic benches as well. So we could put maybe a few of these outside. All right, gotta stay focused, you guys. I do have to find the archway if we are even going to have one. So let's see what we have for options. We do also have these very interesting signs as well, which I think could be very useful for tourists here. Because we do have the ski slopes, so if we want to direct guests to where they need to go, I think that's a really great sign. All right, for the entrance itself, that is going to be a little bit tricky. Additionally, I do like this object as well, so I could put it just about here. It does kind of mirror the look of the hotel, which I think is a plus. So let me try out this option. All right, guys, so I'm kind of having second thoughts about the fence. I feel like all of the buildings are very structured, and then the fence itself is extremely rustic. So I think I will default to the snowy escape one once more, and I will replace all of these fence pieces. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. All right, there's my basic symmetry there. All right, I think this is looking pretty good so far. I do have to flesh out the back area a little bit because we don't really have a lot of stuff for the onsen or natural spring element of this lot. So perhaps I can squeeze in maybe some lockers or something like that. Unfortunately, we also don't have another roof structure, which is going to be a little bit tricky. Theoretically, I guess you could change on the inside, but I do think we need more lights, so let me bring these out over here. All right, pop them in just like this. All right, so we might have a slight change in plans. I do want some kind of perhaps changing area out here. I know this is not going to be super authentic by any means, but I figured that if you are coming out of the hot springs in this very cold, blustery weather, and you have to run all the way around to get back into your unit, I do think some kind of changing area would be nice here. So with that said, unfortunately, I will do away with these sort of stilted foundations, and I do think a nice sort of rock texture like this could possibly do the trick, just so that I can actually make a wall towards the back that sits flush and doesn't have the weird stilted foundation underneath. All right, so this is the foundation now. I will go back over here now and also move some of these lights over that we won't really need anymore. Now, I don't think this will make more tiles if I do something like this and then possibly make a little bit of an extended wall going this way, possibly something like this. All right, we definitely need some lights in here. So let me bring back these and just place them along the wall like this. I could actually make it somewhat symmetrical to the roof. It's going to be a little off because the build is not quite perfectly symmetrical. But perhaps if I balance it out like this, we can just close that gap a little bit more. The roof situation is a little weird, you guys, but I think half gabled is the way to go just to provide a little bit of an overhang. It's a huge roof, but we will shrink this down like this and try to blend it into the current roof situation. I will now go ahead and add some lockers in from the Snowy Escape Pack, just so that if your Sims are stuck out here in the cold, you have a really quick way to change your clothes and hopefully stay warm. I can only imagine how cold it is getting out of the springs and then really, really rushing into your unit, which is all the way around here. Maybe it's not the best design, but here we are. Here we are indeed. I also would like some kind of bench to the right of this as well, just to make putting on robes and coats a little bit easier. So I just realized that we do not have any kind of food option. We did have the mini fridges inside, but if there was something in terms of amenities, I think we could possibly do a vending machine, which of course we're gonna pull from the Snowy Escape Pack once more. All right, do we have one that is specifically food, preferably something warm? We have hot eats, so that's actually not too bad. This could work maybe out here. I'll probably move maybe these over to the side over here with the bench in the middle, and then the little vending machine out in the corner like this. I think this should do the trick. Additionally, I could also do a sign. Again, onsen related, I do think we have some from Snowy Escape. Again, pretty much the same stuff everywhere. All right, so for all the options we have, I think this is probably the best fit, the onsen style informative plaque. So let's probably put one right about here and then probably find a nice image to work with. All right, I think this option is pretty fitting. It shows you how to store your clothes in the lockers, which is absolutely perfect. And I think this pretty much finishes the outside. On second thought, I totally forgot the trash can, so I'm not really sure where I'm going to put it. But I do know that I want to use probably my favorite option, which is the get-together trash can. I guess back here next to the vending machine? It's not really the most inspired location, but I think it'll do. And it does have a little bit of an overhang as well. All right, guys, so this is pretty much it. This is the completed 32-tile hotel in the world of Mount Komorebi. So overall, I'm actually pretty happy with how this came out. I was definitely going for something more Japanese-inspired, kind of taking inspiration from ryokans and also onsens as well. So we do have three individual units, and we also have a little check-in area with the measly two tiles I had left, but hopefully it does function, but if not, it certainly is there for realism's sake. If you do have a worker on duty there, hopefully checking in the guests and giving some directions perhaps. Looking at the units themselves, they are pretty much the same throughout, but of course this is a hotel, so it's kind of expected. But honestly, you guys, I was really surprised with how much we could actually cram in these little tiny rooms. I think each of these rooms was only 10 tiles. So we do have two beds here. We have a mini fridge with a TV set from the Tiny Living Pack, but we do have this wonderful object from the Snowy Escape Pack as well, hopefully to hang a lot of your coats and hats and everything else to keep you warm. We do also have a little tiny space heater, which I hope keeps you warm. And of course, the classic three-tile bathroom that I love, and of course, is made possible by this wonderful shower right here. Honestly, the landscaping was probably one of my favorite parts of this build because I did get to use a lot of the Snowy Escape debug with this archway here, with these signs as well, with the sort of activity board, I would say, and of course, all of these wonderful trees and rocks from the pack as well. We do have a nice picnic spot on each side with the lanterns kind of lighting the way to the natural spring. So if you're willing to brave it all in the cold, we do have a hot spring over here, and I did create a little overhang towards this area as well. So you do have your lockers for your clothes, a bench to change, of course some trash cans, and if you are very hungry and need something to warm you up, we do have this lovely vending machine, which I do hope your Sims enjoy. Overall, I hope you guys really enjoyed the challenge. I know it was really fun for me trying to design this very, very tiny hotel with only 32 tiles, but I would say this is definitely a place I would like to use with my Sims, and if you guys do get the Sims 4 for rent expansion pack, I'd imagine the lot is not too expensive and you'd be able to rent out these units for fairly low money as well. On that note, if you guys have more ideas for build challenges, please feel free to share them in the comments. Like always, it doesn't matter if they're weird, wonky, super difficult, I'm really open to anything. With that said, I will see you all in the very next build challenge. And of course, just like always, this has been TownieSimBuilds, signing off. Thank you so much for watching, guys.